Kritika Sehgal, and I welcome you here in Tech Talks. I have with me right now Mr. Jitendra Nalwaya, Vice President BSES-Yamuna. Hello, sir.
Hi, hello.
I have a few questions for him right now, and I'll be asking those questions to him, and let's start.
Sure, please.
So, India is planning to go electric in 2030. So, don't you think so that this target is very ambitious?
No, I don't think so. The target is very ambitious because government is also pushing hard to make this happen. And with the consumer behavior we are having and with the technology change, which is very fast technology change and kind of adoption by the consumer, especially in India, is very fast. I think this will going to start soon. I mean, maybe by next year you will see some kind of surge. And I really feel the target is quite low. I mean, 2030 should be 2025, something like that. Because EV is future, and like when we talk about so much of pollution in Delhi or in India, when we talk about so much of consumption of oil and something like that, I mean, we should firstly switch to the electric vehicle, provided there should be some kind of renewable integration, renewable influx, more kind of renewable influx, which is already taken care by the government.
All right. What, according to you, are the challenges that the country is going to face to get into this league?
Right now, when we presently the challenges, mainly challenges is on the policy and technical kind of thing. When there's the specifications and the documentation and the other kind of things are not in place, and everybody is working on them in that direction. And infrastructure will be a key challenge in future, because the kind of infrastructure the utilities are having, I mean, and to take care of those peak loading and other thing, and that requires some kind of technical studies. But as we have done previously also, if I talk about Delhi, I mean, we are already handled 7,000 megawatt and it was 5,000 megawatt 2 years back. So we are well prepared on that, but some technical studies and some technical papers needs to be done on this on very urgent basis, so that we get prepared by next year, by next to next year.
All right, so while we are talking about the challenges, if we compare India with other countries, what other countries are doing, they are using electrified vehicles, and they are going for then hybrid vehicles, and then for plug-in hybrid vehicles. But India at the same time is only promoting lithium-ion battery electric vehicles. So is it going to be a challenge itself for India?
I think if we see from the consumer's perspective, I mean, consumer will require all kind of combination to be available with him. It's not only EV vehicle. Consumer may go for hybrid kind of thing, consumer may go for plug-in kind of thing, he may go for the, I mean, somebody may say, I don't want EV also. There are some consumers. And if you talk about other countries like Sri Lanka, they are mainly in hybrid. Like Dubai, they have just started. So I think the change will come, and this is something like a chicken egg kind of a story. When the infra will be there, those changes will be there, and the consumer behavior will change. But at the end of the day, all the options should be available to the, and will be available to the consumers. It can't be one.
All right. So coming back to lithium-ion batteries and coming to the lithium itself, lithium is not an easy task, I guess. So can we say this lithium is going to be the next oil for the country?
I think some countries like Congo and other countries are betting on that, but if we talk about India perspective, I mean Indian perspective, I mean we are importing oil right now, and it should not be in the case that we should start importing lithium in the future. I mean many companies are doing research in this, and they are coming, some are coming with the fuel cell kind of things and other things, but some innovation, some more R&D needs to be done. And I mean, if you ask my feeling, it will be there will be some kind of breakthroughs in future. Maybe in next 4 or 5 years, we will see some kind of fuel cell technologies, some kind of other technologies which will going to run the batteries. It will be there, but I mean, for the next decade, lithium will surely capture the market, and it will give some nation very good impact.
Right. Absolutely right. And then I just want to know your opinion on how do you see India in next 5 to 10 years in terms of EV?
See, like, I mean, if we talk about next 5 to, because since last 1 year, we have been started talking about the EV very seriously. And now with such indication of EV, now the things are moving very fast from the government policy angle and electricity angle also. And I mean, my feeling is here from next year, it will going to start. And next 5 years, we will see the major A and class B, class A and class B city, where the two-wheelers and some kind of fleet management and bus transport vehicle will take over, EV will take over to the mainly fuel. Private vehicle may take some time now. We are not sure how the consumer behavior, because the parking issues, other kind of issues, charging infra issues will be there. But it will be there, but as of now, in next 5 years, transport vehicle, fleet vehicle, and two-wheeler and auto and other thing will take over. EV will take over.
All right, we are looking forward for this thing, and I hope we see India being electric in 2030 itself. Thank you so much for joining us here. Thank you so much, guys. We'll be back with another new topic and exciting technologies. And till then, bye.
Bye.